very happy that we are turning a page, and it's almost like we're taking the city back, right? But we're doing it one step at a time.
Last night, we brought you the story of Maritza Beniquez. She's an emergency room nurse in New Jersey, my home state, and yesterday, on her birthday, she became the first person in the state to get vaccinated. We were so moved by her story that we had to tell you more about it. She called getting the vaccine an honor, and she said she hopes the image of her taking the shot helps combat skepticism among people of color.
I understand their fears, I do. But I'm here to say to my community, to my people, to my Latinos and to my Blacks and to just everyone around the world, this vaccine is safe. It has been. I wouldn't take it if it wasn't safe. I have a family too. I am just like you.
Joining me now is Maritza Beniquez, an emergency room nurse at University Hospital in my home state of New Jersey. It's located in Newark, New Jersey. Thank you for being here. yes, Jersey girls. Okay, so there are reports that a healthcare worker in Alaska who also took the Pfizer vaccine had some side effects and some adverse reactions. How are you feeling after taking it? I know a lot of people are curious, you know, do you feel soreness in your arm? What are some of the effects you're feeling, if any?
You know, I woke up this morning and I feel fabulous. You know, I woke up, I had some soreness in my arm, but it's normal. It's expected. It's what I expected. We got a shot in the arm. And so, and I had a small headache last night, but I was okay. I took some Tylenol and I was good. I mean, if that's the worst that I can expect from this, this, you know, vaccine, then bring it on. Bring it on.
Well, absolutely. And in terms of also the peace of mind that it affords you as you go out as a frontline worker, working with patients every day, does it give you an increased peace of mind to know that you are yourself protected from COVID potentially through this vaccine?
Absolutely. Absolutely. The peace of mind that I get, you know, going into a patient's room, because we don't know each other. I don't know any of these patients. I don't know where they were at, you know, an hour ago. And I've already lived COVID. I already know what it is. You know, we're not talking about the 80% of people that, you know, catch this virus and will be okay with it. And, you know, they'll catch maybe cold-like symptoms or not have any symptoms. We're talking about the 20% that come in. And those are the ones that are suffering the most severe symptoms, the worst of this disease. And I've seen what it does ravaging the body. There's no distinction between if I were to clone myself into two different people or you into two different people, I couldn't tell you which one of you is going to walk away with minimal to none versus severity to death. There's no line there. So it makes it, you know, it's unnerving to go into a room and not know whether today is going to be the day that you're going to get infected and be next on that list. So for me, you know, that peace of mind that now I have something to fight back with, not just that I have something to fight for my body to fight back with, but that this nation, that we can take back this nation because it has been taken from us by a little bug. People, you know, have lost their jobs, have lost their homes, kids at home. Some have paid the ultimate price, and that's with their lives. So we are not in a position to say that, oh, let's sit back and wait, and maybe, you know what, by next year we'll have herd immunity and it'll go away. People are suffering right now. And whatever I can do to make sure that my patients stay safe, because if I'm safe and I am healthy, I am able to give the best possible care to my patient. If I am sick and I am not there, your chances are a whole lot less, you know. So, and I'm not just saying because I'm a super nurse, because look how many nurses, how many doctors we have across our nation. We are tired and it's only human. You can't expect your workforce to be sick and delivering care to other patients, no? So this is a lifeline in so many ways for so many people. I'm sorry.
That's so important. And we all need to hear that too, because I think sometimes we have a tendency to take people for granted, depending mm-hmm. upon which professions they're in. But I take nurses are angels sent from heaven. And so I want frontline workers, nurses and doctors to be protected so that they have the peace of mind so they can provide the best care. And the last question I have is about representation. I think it's really important mm-hmm. that some of the first Americans to receive the vaccine are people of color. And there is some skepticism in communities of color about the medical industry and also the vaccine. But as you mentioned, we're more likely to be infected and severely ill. Do you hope mm-hmm. that the image of you taking the vaccine will encourage others to do the same?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, and I have to say it's justifiable and it's palpable, the fear that people feel, right? It's justifiable if you think about it, because I'm also a woman of color and I hear the stories. I remember the history. I have studied and read enough to know that the things that frighten us are things that are not in our distant past. They are things that have happened within this last century. So I understand the fear, that skepticism. But you know, Dr. Purnell, she's one of the doctors that works at our institution. She said something so important, and that was that it's not up to the public to trust us on blind faith. We have to earn that trust from them. So I hope that by seeing me, that from my story, from the things that I have seen, witnessed, and my willingness to be there for people, that if they see that in me, that they too, my people, will follow. And we have to be able to come together. And there's a time and a place for fear and debate. And there's a time and a place where we're at that line. We cannot wait anymore. We cannot sit back any longer. We can't lose any more people. I've seen enough to know that we can't lose one more person. One person is too much. No. So,
absolutely.
I hope that.
Absolutely. Maritza Beniquez, thank you. Thank you so much. And thank you for your service and your work every single day, taking care of your fellow Americans.